This one says, yes, I'm go.
We done got everybody woke up now.
Go.
Go
ahead and hit the
ready to go? Gotcha.
No. I don't think that work either. Hey, I know. Go ask your mom and your grandma, that Kay.
Grandma, that's terrible. I can't ask mom, but I still love you. Let's go find one of them. I'm sure they can help me.
Man, yeah, that sounds good to me. That lets me off the hook. Yeah, let's go find him, son. Come on, I think you're in the kitchen. Is everything that your mom and daddy asked you to do, is it always real clear as to why you need to do it? In other words, if they say, I want you to go over there and stand. Do you say, okay, and you're like, all right, they know what they're doing. Or you're like, what? What do I need to do that for? Yeah. Just like you was really wanting to say, why, brother Darren, why do I need to come up here and sit on front pew? Mm-hmm. But you did it. But it didn't make any sense, did it? No. Well, I'm going to make it make more sense for you. Do you believe that if I tell you something, do you believe that I'm trying to do it to help you or to be good for you? Do you believe when I tell you something, you say, well, he's a little older than I am. Maybe he knows more than I do. Now, Sister Shauna had a hard time understanding this concept. She thinks that she knows more than all of us the rest of us. Anyway, only something. But do you know if I tell you something, do you believe me? Will you have faith in me enough to believe that I can do something? See this piece of paper? Do you believe I can take this piece of paper and make it go completely over your body? Huh? You don't believe that? Just show me. Do you believe that I can take this piece of paper and make it completely go over Adrian's body?
Yes.
You did?
Yes.
How am I going to do that?
You stick it on his head and pull him through it.
I can make this piece of paper go all the top of it, maybe all the way over?
No, but all the way over.
Okay.
Okay.
But see, here's the thing. We don't always know exactly why we're being told different things and told to do things. Adrian didn't know why I asked him to come up here. So now, I'm going to have to show him that I can make that piece of paper go over here. So, while I'm doing that, let me tell you a little story. In Ezekiel, the book of Ezekiel, we read there about the prophet Ezekiel. He says that the Lord came to him, took him into the Spirit, and he began to talk to him, show him things, and tell him things. And he showed him a valley that was full of dry bones. And the Lord told him, he said, do you believe that these bones can live again? And Ezekiel, he's kind of like you was. He said, I don't know about all that. So he said, thou knowest, Lord. So the Lord told him, he said, prophesy unto these bones. He said, tell them, I'm going to put flesh back on them. I'm going to put breath back into them. And I'm sure Ezekiel was probably thinking, okay. That's kind of weird. Now, I don't think I can make that go over you yet. So let me work on it a little bit more here. So Ezekiel, he did what the Lord told him to do just because, the Lord told him to. Well, the Bible says that when he did that, and why? Because he obeyed the Lord showed him that those bones started rattling in that old valley. Mm-hmm. And they started coming together.
That's right.
And as they came together, the Lord breathed into them and they became back alive. So, it shows us there that we have to be willing to obey the Lord no matter what. If we think that it might be something weird, or we think, well, why? Just know that it is the Lord's will for us to obey Him, and that everything will be just like we need it to be, just like He intends for it to be. So, When your parents tell you to do something, you may not understand it. When your pastor asks you to do something, you may not understand it. But just know that just because you don't understand it doesn't mean that it's not something that you need to do. Now, Adrian, are you going to listen to me? I want you to come right here, stand right here, and I want you to face to my peer, come up on the platform, up on the platform. Good job. Now, I want you to stand right there and don't move your arms, hold still. And I'm going to take this piece of paper and I'm going to make it go right on top of you. There you go. There you go. And yes, Shauna, I may show you how to do that after a while, just because I know you love paper stuff.
Can you do it with me too?
Oh, she said her too.
But see, if you hadn't obeyed, you would have never learned that right there.
That's right.
You would have never learned that. Because we never know what our parents are asking. We never know, as parents, we never know what is being asked of us of God. That's and awesome. A lot of the time, God may ask you to do something, and you, of course, our most adults, our first answer is, is that you, Lord? Are you sure that's you? Don't question him.
Amen.
He may be fixing to bring something to life that's been dead.
Amen.
It may be something in you. It may be something in someone else.
Amen.
So just know that when we obey those that have the rule over us, when we obey our parents, then good things come. But like the Bible said there in Colossians, I go back because most of us have probably forgotten exactly what I read. Colossians 3:20 says, children, obey your parents in all things. Why? For this is well-pleasing unto the Lord. When you obey your parents, you make God happy.
That's right.
When you obey your parents, you of course you make them happy, but you make God happy.
Amen.
Because God put them there for a protection and for a help.
That's right.
Amen. So, just remember today, kids, and every day, remember to just obey the Lord. And let him be a blessing to you, and you're a blessing to him.
Amen.
God bless you this morning. We love you.
Amen.